الحمد لله، اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على آل إبراهيم، وبعد، we read in the hadith of the authentic narrations that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says من قال لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. Anyone who says لا إله إلا الله, there is no God, there is no deity with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Allah doesn't have any partner. Then he will go to Jannah. And I used to hear long time ago when I was a teenager, some people understand it that you just say it, that's enough. You need not make salah, according to them. Even if you are involved in any haram, you have something that will give you immunity, that you say La ilaha illallah, then that's enough, you will go to Jannah. I want to explain this to you today. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, as a scholar, wrote a book entitled Al-Iman. It is 600 pages almost. He says that for Arabs early in history, before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is commissioned as a messenger, it is their nature and their culture, when they say something, approve it, they do it. So he says qala and amila are the same. Because when you say something, it means you do it. This is why the Quran in Surah As-Saff says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Why do you say something, you don't do it? So then, when you say La ilaha illallah, it means you do accordingly, according to what you utter or what you say. And Ibn Taymiyyah in his book Al-Iman, he says qala, alima and amila, the three verbs are in common for one meaning. It is action. And Al-Imam al-Shatibi in his book Al-Muwafaqat, volume 1, has 13 introductions. His book of Usul al-Fiqh, the basics of Sharia, at the beginning he explains and illustrates 13 introductions. One of them says, we acquire knowledge for action. Islamically, a Muslim won't seek for knowledge in order to acquire knowledge. We don't learn to learn. We learn to do. This is why Al-Imam Malik rahimahullah, when somebody asked him a theoretical question, asked him, did it happen to you? You see, if anyone asked me a question, I always ask, if it is theoretical, I say, did it happen? Is it going to happen? Don't waste time to discuss. There are many, many questions that people have those questions in their currency which are of no benefit to discuss or to learn. So then again, qala, to say, or alima, to acquire knowledge, or did, took action, are synonyms, are of the same family, of the same family. So then, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Man qala la ilaha illallah," it means he acquired the knowledge, he said la ilaha illallah, and he is going to live for what he says. Then, any other type of people who say something different, anyone who differs in action from what he says in his utterance, this phenomenon is a phenomenon of nifaq. It is not the nature of the Muslim. It is not the nature of the Muslim to say something different. So this is my point number one. We should understand that a Muslim never have a different image of what he says, of what he knows, of what he does. And La ilaha illallah is the key of Islam, is the key of Islam. My point number two, Al-Islam is the combination and collection and the gathering of all systems, systems of this universe. The one who study chemistry, the one who study biology, the one who study medicine, the one who study IT computer, the one who study anything, they have something in common. What they study, they are learning the discoveries of systems, those systems called Islam. So Al-Islam is the only way to express or to identify the laws of Allah in this universe. And you read in the Quran, وَلَهُ أَسْلَمَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ طَوْعًا وَكَرْهًا وَإِلَيْهِ يُرْجَعُونَ. To him accepted and submitted themselves as Muslims voluntarily or involuntarily. Then when we say Al-Islam, it deals with the chemist, because the chemist knows the laws of chemistry which are laws of Islam. When you say HSO4, HSO4, this is a chemical formula. I, as a Muslim, I say HSO4 to be certain substance is, yes, it is a chemical, but this law is of Islam. When you study math, you study logarithm, you study sine, cosine, all these are laws of Islam. It is not enough to say the Quran is the book of Islam. Yes, the Quran is the book of guidance. But when you come to other details of this universe, everything of those systems are established by Allah. And if we discover anything of what we have of discoveries, we discover something which is initiated started and systemized by Allah. I want you to understand that. So when we talk about salah, for me it is not different from the operation of the doctor. When you go to a doctor and he says you should have a heart operation, I look at the heart operation by that cardiologist. I see that what the cardiologists do in taking the heart out and stopping the heart and putting a machine, everything of that similar to the one who is making ruku' and sujood. Because making ruku' and sujood are inevitably needed for man. If a person doesn't make salah, it's similar to the one who says, I can live without a heart. Or I can live without lungs. Or I can live without a kidney. I need not my kidney to work. What insane this person is. But we say about that person insane. Why don't we say to the one who says, I can make my life without salah, why don't we call him insane? Think about it. So then, you should understand, I look at the salah, I look at siyam, I look at zakah, I look at hajj, I look at any obligation of deen, similarly to anything of our necessities, like to be a medical operation or saving a drowned person in water. When you see somebody who is going to be drowned in water, what would you do? You would save him. Saving that one who is going to die, if you don't take care of him, is similar to observance of salah or giving zakah or going to hajj. I hope that you are listening to me, are you? Or I'm talking to myself. Do you think I am sane in exposing that? Alhamdulillah, I understand that I am sane. So these are basics of knowledge. When you send your son to school, the first time your son goes to school, what do you do when he comes back? Oh, you give a kiss and a hug to your son because you love him. I don't know if he loves you or not, this is not my business. So, the first question you forward to your son, come sweetheart, what did you learn today? What did you learn today? Oh, daddy, the teacher told us 1 + 1 = 2. Oh, great. You see? Then why don't you try to know anything around you is the guidance to maintain good life? If I ask you, who doesn't want a good, happy life? No one will raise his hand. Everyone I know, if I read your heart, everyone is dreaming of having a good house, a good car, a good wife, a good children, peaceful life. I don't know if he thinks to go to Jannah or not. But I assume he is thinking of Jannah. Jannah is in need of some explanation and details. Especially I know that there is a critical subject matter, which is Al-Hur Al-Ain, because many men here are dreaming of Al-Hur Al-Ain, as if they have nothing in Jannah other than Al-Hur Al-Ain. They are partially sick. Anyhow, inshallah someday maybe I explain. So then, brothers, sisters, daughters, sons, I have 2 points today. Firstly, as a Muslim, when you say something or when you acquire knowledge for something, it is for action. Then what you do is what you know is what you say. That is my point number one. Point number two, الدين الإسلام means to comply with the universal laws, being of medicine, being of chemistry, being of geology, being of accountants, being of whatsoever. Everything is in the basket of Islam. I'd like you, when you go out, if somebody asks you, what did Sheikh Hanouti speak today? Say to him, he spoke about two points. One, من قال لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. And the other thing, that everything of a system, of order, of law is Islam. Al-Islam means to be fully submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last thing, the women are making a good project outdoor to help our Muslim brothers and sisters in Syria. So they are asking for you to cooperate with them. They are collecting some fund in order to buy clothes to send it to Syria, as the winter is coming in 1 month, 2 months. So inshallah, as the sisters are volunteers to give their time and their effort, I want you to do something deals with your pockets. Don't forget to put your hand in your pocket. The last thing, I'd like you not to forget Dar al-Hijrah. I don't know why the funds that are collected last Fridays are going down. And usually the office of Dar al-Hijrah blame me. And some say to me, you should pay the difference. I'd like you today to pay the difference. اللهم انصر إخواننا المجاهدين في كل مكان. اللهم أعنهم على من ظلمهم. اللهم انصرهم نصرا مؤزرا يا رب العالمين. اللهم خذ بأيديهم. اللهم مكنهم في أعدائهم. واجعلهم هم الغالبين. واجعل أعداءك هم المغلوبين يا رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة.